Hey everybody, Rich Lovell with the Vacaville Baseball Barn, Master Instructor of the Epstein Hitting System and Online Hitting Academy. If you haven't done so already, please hit the subscribe button and don't forget to click the notifications button to get future videos. So I want to start it's a four-part series. It's easy steps to improving your swing to include bat speed and power. First step that I would say, and this is more for the younger players and coaches and parents, if you're looking for something to kind of guide your kids on, this is how you can really start their swings and so forth. They can either have a bat or not have a bat in their hands. What we really want to start doing, yes, we want to teach what we see from video, but we also want to start teaching these kids how to feel and the different feelings that they're going to have. One of the biggest things that I do with the kids as I begin to really perfect their technique as I get into teaching them different rhythm motions, and this is what I'm talking about. What we want to do is stay to the inside part of our feet, keeping our knees inside our feet, and all we really have to do is just kind of rock them back and forth. And it's similar to an infielder as they get ready to play and they get their glove in the ready position and their knees come in and we get pressure to the insides of their feet. Just have the kids kind of rock back and forth. They don't necessarily have to pick their feet up, but they can a little bit. And the more they rock like this, then you get them to settle down a little bit more. And we have a phrase or a term that we use about staying in the legs, then make sure they're keeping their legs slightly flexed or their knees slightly flexed. Don't have them way out over in front of their toes, but just back and forth, just back and forth. This is one of those things that you can do over and over and over. Once they start getting comfortable with this, then make those movements a little bit smaller to where now only the heels are coming up, to the point to where the back heels start staying on the ground, the front heel's coming up, and they're just going in like this. You can see how this knee kind of pinches in a little bit. Again, I'm not doing any major turning. I'm just getting them to start understanding that we want to shift weight from center of one foot to center of the other foot. And when I refer to that, I mean the ankles. So as I go from my back heel into my front heel, I'm thinking centered over my ankles, and then I'm creating ground force. It's minor right now, but that will improve. And then they can advance that to where now what they're doing is going into their front foot, but I'm stabilizing my head over the center part of my body. As they become more and more comfortable with that, then advance it another step where they come in here and then maybe pinch his back knee in, keeping the front shoulder down. All the other technique portions of the swing that we talk about stay in play, but then it's just boom. But it all started with maybe feet a little closer together, rocking back and forth, big head movement, big movement. It doesn't really matter. They start to settle that down. They move into the positions here. Then they get their feet at the proper distance, and then it becomes front heel comes up a little bit as they turn, and then boom. And then it's back until they finally begin to work the back hip, and then where they can begin to work the upper body. So that's the first part of it. There'll be three more parts to this, so stay tuned for it. And remember, don't forget to subscribe, share with your friends, players, and teammates. Check out our Facebook feed for upcoming camps and events. And if you want to do any private lessons with me, book it through us here at the barn, or if you're out of my area, look at the online academy. I think you'll like it.